In the right. Okay, ready, here we go.
And forever, I love you. I love you. And when I'm praying, I hear him saying, I love you. I love you. People all over the world, they're opening up, they're coming around, and they're saying, I love you, 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 I love you. I love you, 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 I love you.
Thank you. good evening. Tonight, we gather to celebrate the many accomplishments of the class of 2020. The moments that we will share this evening are bittersweet. We'll not only look back on all the fond memories of our 6 years at prep, we'll also be looking toward the future and all of the wonderful experiences we have yet to enjoy. As we acknowledge the many accomplishments of our grade over these past 6 years, we also recognize how instrumental prep has been in shaping our lives. Whether we identify as students, athletes, artists, performers, leaders, or some combination thereof, we owe an enormous debt of gratitude to the prep community for helping us become the people we are today. To the faculty at this school, thank you for consistently and selflessly dedicating yourself to the student body. Whether they served as teachers, coaches, or staff members, the faculty at Flintridge Prep worked day in and day out to ensure that we received the best education possible. More than anything else, they inspired us to be passionate about the things that we care about and to never settle for less than the best versions of ourselves. Secondly, to our parents and families, many of whom sacrificed so much to send us to this school. You've been there every step of our journeys, cheering us on and helping us find the right path to success. Thank you for giving us all the opportunity to come together as a class and for providing the unconditional love that we needed to make it here. And lastly, to the students of Flintridge Prep, and especially to the class of 2020, thank you for being the reason why people are proud to go to prep. You are some of the most talented, inspiring, kind-hearted people I have ever known, and I have absolutely no doubts that each one of us will take the prep values that we cherish, honesty, kindness, generosity, and respect, and use them to make an impact on this world. And I am eager to see what our futures hold. So, to the class of 2020, prep's last and best rebels, thank you all for everything.
Thank you, Maya. And thank you, Jeffrey, and the Flintridge Singers. I normally ask people to be seated at this time, but I suspect you already are. So welcome to 2020 Commencement Part 1. We are planning a face-to-face Part 2, and with that in mind, have imagined both programs, saving for Part 2 such features as Charlie's Benton and Maya's founders' addresses and other forms of student recognition. Today, we've woven together features of baccalaureate, the senior dinner, and traditional commencement, making this ceremony as student-driven as possible. The highlight, of course, will be the awarding of diplomas, and we invite parents to present them when the names and the portrait are featured. We have saved the individualized diploma covers to present to you face-to-face. But the diplomas are signed and legal, so you're all good. One feature of the traditional ceremony we're highlighting tonight is the elected class speaker, who I've known virtually his entire life since he was a young fan in the gym and on the field. I taught his dad and concur with the commonly understood notion that the son is already better behaved than the father. During his years at prep, he has grown remarkably, athletically, academically, and personally. I've been privileged to serve as his advisor and his teacher, and also privileged to witness at close quarters his personal courage last fall as he fought through a major back injury to support his football team. He personifies prep for life. The 2020 class speaker is Jack Crawford.
Mr. Bachman, teachers, parents, and fellow graduates, welcome to tonight's virtual graduation celebration. I'm truly honored that you, my classmates, and friends have asked me to speak on your behalf tonight. Our four-year journey that started with a class trip to Catalina Island is now drawing to a close. It's been a fantastic 4 years, and we have much to be grateful for. Any list of things that the class of 2020 is grateful for would have to start with our amazing leader, Mr. Bachman. Our class has named him the 100th member of the Flintridge Prep graduating class of 2020. Whereas we all took 4 years to complete high school, it took Mr. Bachman 40. I'm sure he's been waiting for this day to come for a long, long time. I can say without a fear of being contradicted that he has left the school a far better place than when he started here in the fall of 1979. On a personal note, Mr. Bachman, you have been an amazing and caring mentor to me in all my years at the school, and I cannot thank you enough. We are also thankful to all the other teachers who have played such a critical role in providing us with an amazing education and getting us prepared for college. They were also there to share a laugh and put up with our good-natured humor. In particular, the class would like to thank Mr. Lewis so much for his time here at Prep. After 12 years, he is now moving to Northern California and a new chapter in his life. He has helped build the whole art program to incredible new levels, and we cannot thank him enough. On a personal note, I'd like to give a huge shout out to Mr. Shelton, who has been my English teacher for 3 years and has been a great mentor to me. Mr. Shelton, if you ever need a guest speaker down the line, don't even hesitate to call, because you know I'll come for you. One last person I'd like to give a shout out to is ICE. ICE has kept our campus safe for all 4 years of our high school experience and has been a great friend to all of us during these last 4 years. We are also thankful for all our coaches over the last 4 years. Athletics have played an important part in my life at Flintridge Prep, and I know it has for many of my classmates as well. None of it would have been possible without the great leadership from our coaches. Playing football at Prep was an awesome experience for me. Having such a big senior class made this year special because there were so many leaders out on the field. Even though we had 8 season-ending injuries, we fought hard for one another because we didn't want to let each other down. We went 9-3 and ended up as the second best team in the state, reaching the semifinals. One thing about the season best captures what is so special about the class of 2020. In games when we got far ahead of the other team, and that kind of happened pretty often because we were pretty dang good, Coach White would put in the underclassmen to get them more playing time. Every time one of them would make a big play and return to the sidelines, all the seniors would be hyping them up and encouraging them, and it was just so unique. School spirit was at its highest during these games and at all Prep athletic events. Last but certainly not least, we owe a great debt of gratitude to our parents. None of us would be here without their love and support. My mom and dad have been my biggest supporters for the last 4 years and my entire life. Almost every football game I played, they were right there on the sidelines, loudly cheering me on. They encouraged me to make great friends, were there for me when times were tough, and supported me throughout my entire journey. I've had their unconditional love for my entire life, and I cannot thank them enough. I'm sure all of you feel the same way about your parents. Mr. Bachman and the other administrators, our teachers, our coaches, and our parents have created an amazing high school experience for the class of 2020. Not only have we gotten a great education, but we've learned values that will stay with us as we go off to college and through the rest of our lives. So what makes the class of 2020 so special? Our class is one of the most diverse classes to ever graduate from Flintridge Prep. While we all hang with our own friend groups, we still like and respect one another as a class. We are always there to help one another. This class spirit has been best exemplified during the current COVID-19 crisis. No graduating class has ever had to deal with anything like this, but we've stayed connected with one another over social media and are constantly reminding each other about how much we miss one another as a senior class. A second thing that distinguishes our class is its curiosity and originality. When I asked some of our teachers what made our class special, they said we were adventurous and willing to take risks in pursuing our academics. Third, the class of 2020 has a great sense of humor. We've had more than our fair share of pranks and jokes to keep both ourselves and the faculty entertained over the last 4 years. Whether it was having Wi-Fi issues in the middle of my answer on a Zoom call with Mr. Frost, which I don't know what I was thinking, it was a lapse of judgment, but seemed hilarious at the time, a debate over whether milk is a beverage, broth, or a sauce, and if you think it's a sauce, I don't get that, but whatever, or Alex Payne's entertaining videos, we've always found a way to have fun and not take ourselves too seriously. Finally, we have shown great school spirit throughout our 4 years here. Whether it was homecoming or a Pack the Place event or any ordinary game, it was so much fun having the mob root on their classmates to victory. While there is a lot of uncertainty about what is in store for us next year, we will go off to college at some point. The class of 2020 is more than ready. We have gotten a great education at Prep and have learned important values not only from the school, but from our parents. I know we are all going to go on and do great things in the years ahead. but we need to stay close as a class. We need to keep these great friendships that we've built over the last 4 years. My dad graduated from Flintridge Prep in 1986. Today, his closest friends are still a group of guys he graduated with that year. That's what I want to be able to say 30 years from now. And with that, I wish you all good luck at college. Have fun, make good decisions, be tolerant, and stay humble. And most importantly, stay in touch. Love you all with all my heart. Thank you so much. Prep for life, and go Rebels.
Thank you, Jack, very much. It is customary for the class president to make presentations on behalf of the graduates. At admissions open house every year, I invite two or three seniors to join me in Norris to answer questions. I try to select people who embody the breadth and depth of the prep experience: academic, athletics, the arts, public service, love of friends, and devotion to the community. This year, I was honored to stand beside Charlie McCormick.
Hello, everyone. It is my pleasure to present both the class gift and the class honor this evening. The class of 2020's contribution to Flintridge Prep consists of three separate gifts: 6 oak trees to complement the Bachman Collaboration Building, new softball dugout seating, and emergency supplies to restock the disaster preparedness bin. I know that we're all looking forward to coming back to campus in the future to see how these gifts, hopefully with the exception of the emergency supplies, are being utilized. And now for the class honor. This year, the class of 2020 has elected to honor Mr. Rob Lewis. Mr. Lewis's impact on us is beyond measure, but my classmate Tess Robertson-Neal has composed a few words about him that I think certainly ring true. Mr. Lewis is more than a drama teacher. He's a source of light and inspiration and a friend. He makes safe spaces from the theaters to the lunch patio and encourages people to be bold. With each smile in the hallway and performance he brings to life on stage, Mr. Lewis connects to those around him and makes them feel seen. He views the students as people who have ideas that are worthy of being heard. Mr. Lewis is thoughtful and caring and joyful in ways beyond words. It is an honor to have him join the extra special class of 2020. Congratulations, Mr. Lewis, and thank you for everything you've done. We wish you all the best on your next adventure.
Thank you, Charlie. I don't know how to thank you enough. I mean, Flintridge Prep has done so much for me that, I mean, like, more for me than anyone could possibly imagine. And it has been an honor spending all of my days growing up with you and growing older with you. And I feel like that alone has been just such a gift. And I just know that every time I show up to a class, or every time I show up to a rehearsal, or just show up to campus, that you can feel this tangible magic, that there's something actually special there. And for me, I think that magic is family. You are my family, and family is for life. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Charlie. Thank you, especially this class of 2020. You have changed me. Thank you.
Now, I'm also here to honor another graduating faculty member with an award that's not actually listed on the program. Each year, the Class of 1987 Service Award is presented to a faculty member Prep students and faculty feel has given outstanding service to the school during the year. This year's recipient has given outstanding service to Prep for 40 years now. From his appearances at football games to his great books classes with us seniors, Mr. Bachman's impact on our school is felt every day. Throughout his time at Prep, Mr. Bachman has been completely devoted to the development of his students as both people and scholars for life. Even after he became headmaster, Mr. Bachman continued to teach, a testament to his service. As you may have guessed from his Walden Moment newsletters, Henry David Thoreau was one of the writers he covered in his great books course. And in his last class with us, he encouraged us to embrace Thoreau's advice, to live deliberately and with truth, advancing confidently in the direction of our dreams. It's truly impossible to capture the breadth of Mr. Bachman's service, but moments like these help to illuminate his importance to the school and its community. As seniors heading out into the big, bright world, Mr. Bachman's compassion and guidance couldn't be more meaningful. Thank you for everything, Mr. Bachman.
Thank you, Charlie. Thank you to the faculty who nominated and the students who selected, and Charlie, of course, for your wonderful words. To receive an award from Charlie McCormick, standing alongside of Rob Lewis in a celebration for the class of 2020, doesn't get much better than that. So, from my heart, thank you. This is an award that I've been around since the award was created, so it's always been the nearest and dearest one to me. So I'm supremely grateful. Now, a trip down memory lane. Each year, Mr. Frost curates a visual recollection of our graduates' journeys. So please enjoy the senior video.
Steps in and He said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I thought heaven can't help me now, nothing lasts forever.
I've got to be where my spirit can't run free. Now listen to me, man, as I endeavor to explain what separates a charlatan from a Charlemagne.
I'll sing you the story of a sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had.
There's nothing to be sure of.
The evergreen pine and the autumn blue
may seem sudden and strange.
It just
pleasant word all day.
But this is gonna take me down. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. I can see the end as it begins. My one condition is, say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe. Red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me
said, no one has to know what we do. His hands are in my hair, his clothes are in my room, and his voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever.
But this is getting good now. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. And when we've had our very last kiss, my last request is, say you'll remember me.
My dad was always talking about Mr. Flintridge Prep. He didn't even go to prep.
It's a whole melting pot. It's not even a melting pot because they're all separate. A highly refined dish that Gordon Ramsay would make with all the ingredients that have a synergy that forms an exquisite, delicious, gourmet entree that is Mr. FP.
We were learning all the dance moves and it came naturally for some people.
Honestly, not.
Favorite song to dance to after the Star Spangled Banner was Yummy.
With Desmos and math, we can measure the stars, but when Flintridge Secure doesn't give you 5 bars, you'll need a quick fix before all of the stress gets to ya.
. 2020, I was there. 2015, I was there. 1979, I was there. Back in the 50s, I was there. I actually founded the school.
Standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe. Red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your
cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just pretend.
Say you'll remember me,
standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe.
Red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just pretend.
Just
pretend. Even if it's just in your eyes.
Mr. Bachman, I present the class of 2020 for graduation. Sarah Nicole Abu-Ross. Maxwell Clemente Alvarez. Shant Shuggy Armenian. Kevin Paul Ashworth. Benjamin James Baraga. Max Barrick. Cole Solaini Barnard. Natalie Bax. Lauren Tyler Bennett. Alec Gregory Bernardi. Ani Michelle Bernardi. Catherine Anasi Besh. Cameron Jean Bilawa. Julia Lynn Boberg. Alexander Lau Bouquet. Jacob Robert Baun. Violet Louise Bretz. Natalie Charisse Brown. Lindsay Michelle Brown. Henry William Bunt. John Michael Cartwright. Pierre Clement Kennedy Cativiella. Alejandro Chagoyan Newman. Ellen Chang. Christopher Aryananda Chang. Miabella Chavez. Caitlin Sarah Chen. Margaret Lynn Cole. Jack Gordon Crawford. J. S. Dadwal. Gage Pascal Dechamendi. Sophia Marie Dragna. Anna Camilla Durfee. Jack Ebright. David Maurice Egan. Jack Zubieta Elliott. Nicholas William Fellows. Lillian Jewel Fox. Sabine Amanda Fragoso. Evan Min Hyung G. Maxwell James Gitlin. Bennett Joseph Grable. Jada Rose Gritton. Luca Marcelo Guzman Gisekin. Gerald Lee Hansen. Jermaine Jeremiah Harvey. Patrick Brian Hastings. Nathan Carl Heller. Bailey Medford Hobie. Noah Powell Igler.
Irene Suri Jang. Jacob Kaplanian. Calvin Katz. Maya Sonali Karana. Andy Kim. Nicholas Alexander Klatsky. Daniel Kotliar. Jason Adam Kreinberg. Alexandra Melina K. Kyriakakis. Audrey Maxine Lawn. Julie Mai Lee. Sophie Paige Lin. Barnett Liu. Melody Liu. Carrie Ning Luk. Karina Ani Mankarian. Charles William McCormick. Gracie Bell McKiernan. Diego Robert Molina Irias. Grady Patrick Morrissey. Leanna Catherine Morrissey. Hannah Mary Davis Murphy. Marguerite May Newhart. Paige Elizabeth Nixon. Emerson Ann Ortel. Eric George Uzunian. Aaron Harrier Uzunian. Alexander Robert Payne. Jeffrey Michael Pendo. Nicholas Tolstoy Revel. Tess Scott Robertson Neal. Jasmine Rachel Samuels. Saya Sharma. Regan Shoji Schmidt. Molly Grace Scott. Sylvie Montjoy Shore. Simon Desser Siskel. Matthew Ho-Chun Sun. Evan Audrey Stevens. Olivia Marilyn Stevens. Noel Sumie Tamura. Derek Tran. Renee Marie Ventresca. Ryan Christopher Waldheim. Wyatt Thomas Walker. McKenna Denise Walklet. Samuel Walton. Sarah Grace Wong. Emily Jia Yuan Yam.
Please join me in saluting all the graduates from the class of 2020. Shout outs. Well deserved. Many people have been involved for many weeks in making these end of the year activities possible. Thanks to senior administrators Midge Kimball, Sarah Cooper, and Vanessa Walker Oaks, to Nicole Trevor in communications, to Lakshmi Jostar Johnson in external affairs, to Sylvie Andrews and the entire tech team, to Brenda Diaz, to the room mothers and the parents, and all the student consultants, and a very special thank you to someone who could not be here tonight. Robert Parker from our class of 78, a colleague of ours, passed away this spring, but his music for many decades has always been part of our commencement proceedings, and we will enjoy it for our recessional in just a few moments. About 25 years ago, PBS presented a series of concerts entitled Unplugged, in which artists reconceived their electronic classics as acoustical presentations. Often a single guitar would accent the notes and the lyrics, and the mood and the perspective. An Eric Clapton scream is reconceived as a gentle lament, moving from the moment of pain into a philosophical reflection on pain, and with other songs, a reflection on quiet delights. This spring, I've drawn your attention to Thoreau's Walden, his experiment in being unplugged. Because we are all feeling unplugged, all feeling stripped down to essentials, without the opportunities we've always taken for granted. So what are we left with when we become unplugged? Graduates, you are tempted by cynicism and despair, justifiably resentful at the loss of the spring you had counted on and deserved. Yet you've responded by embodying the basics of what really matters. Intellectual responsibility matters. Integrity matters. Community and relationships matter. Love matters. So stay armed with these essentials until the next time we meet and in the years to come. And in the meantime, classmates, stay safe and stay close. Take care.
Tonight, we celebrate the class of 2020. Their hard work, their achievements, their relationships, and their memories. And we wish them success and good luck in their journey into the real world. Now, it's impossible not to mention the difficulties that they face in the world today, but it is through those difficulties that their strength, their grit, and their determination shines through. As they move on to this new chapter in their lives, their legacy will be cemented as one of hope and of an undying will to succeed. Additionally, we would like to express our gratitude to those faculty, the administration, the family, and friends who have supported them through both the good times and the bad. And we hope that the class of 2020 will keep that spirit, their kindness, and their pride in what they do. And we hope that carries them to the good life, finding success, sure, but more importantly, happiness. Now, the world truly is not ready for what they can do, and it will feel their impact for years to come. Now, as we bid farewell to this group of friends, this family of seniors, we thank them for their immeasurable impact and contribution to our community and to our campus. And we hold a healthy jealousy to those who will go on to be fortunate enough to call them family in the future. We can't wait to see what you do, and we love you from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you.
Thank you, class of 2020. We want to celebrate and cheer together, so feel free to unmute your mics and we'll close it out together.
Congratulations, guys. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Emily's, if you're out in the audience and you'd like to drop a message into the chat for the class of 2020, please feel free to do that right now.
Congratulations, guys.
Boy, we did it. Oh yeah. Admitted it today.
No, baby!
Let's go.
I don't know if you can hear me, but we've had a request for everyone to throw their caps on camera, so go ahead and do that right now.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yay, Lily! Yay, Easter! Go, Alex! Go, Alex!
Say something, you might get on. I do it.
Okay,
open your dad's.
In the
right.
Okay, ready, here we go.
Josh,
yeah, you do it.
Can you take a photo with this?
Coming.
Max! No arguing.
To me,
let me all
your love.